Hello everyone, let's start exercise 4.2 question number 4. Solve the following equations. See now, equation we can solve by both the methods. Equation can be solved by transpose method also and by balancing methods. Okay, so first I will show you the balancing method.
Whatever operation we are going to do for the left hand side, the same operation we are doing right.
transfer to the right hand side. See, 10B as it is, this plus 10 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. So plus 10 will come to the right hand side, then it will become minus 10. Okay, is equal to this 100 as it is. Now this plus 10 will come to this side, then it will become minus 10. Okay, now 10P is equal to 100 minus 10, 100 minus 10, 90. Okay, now see 10P we got 10P. 10P means 10 times P. Means multiplication. Yes. So this 10 will transfer to the right hand side, then it will become P by 5. See, therefore, here P will be 10. So 90 divided by 10. So 90 divided by 10. So now P is equal to 10 times 10, 10 times 9. So P is equal to 9. So P is equal to 9. See question, P upon 4 is equal to 5. We are going to use now here first balancing method. See, P divided by 4. P divided by 4. So what is opposite of divided? Multiply. So what we are going to do? Multiply by 4 to both the sides. Multiply by 4 to both the sides. See, first I will write both the sides. See, both the sides are left hand side and right hand side. So multiply by 4, both the sides. It is here divide. So multiply by 4, both the sides. So this 4 and this 4. See, 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4. So what will you get here? P. 5 fours are 20. 5 fours are 20. So this understood people. Now let's solve this sum with the transform. See, P upon 4 is equal to 5. P divided by 4 is equal to 5. Now divide it. Here which operation is given? Divide. Now 4 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. Here it is divide. We are going to transfer to the right hand side, then it will become multiplied. See, P is equal to 5 multiplied by 4. So P is equal to 20. 5 fours are 20. So this method is quite easy. So you can use only one method for this. Okay? Which is easy for you, that method you can have. Let's solve question D. Minus P upon 3 is equal to 5. Minus P upon 3 is equal to 5. Now I am going to show using the transposing method. Okay? See now, minus P upon 3, minus P divided by 3, minus P divided by 3. Now 3 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. Yes, 3 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. So what will remain left hand side? Minus P. Yes, we are going to transfer these 3 to the right hand side. So what will remain here? Minus P. Okay, now 3 is here divided. 3 is here divided. Yes, so if it will come to the right hand side, then it will become multiplied. See, once again I will repeat. 3 is here divided. So if it will come to the right hand side, then it will become multiplied. 3 is here divided. If it will come to the right hand side, then it will become multiplied. So minus 3 as it is. 5 threes are 15. 5 threes are 15. Minus P is equal to 15. See, now you are thinking minus P is equal to 15. We want the answer for P. We want the answer for variable. Either you can give this minus sign for 15 or you can transfer this. P you can take this side. And if you will see, P is left hand side, it is minus. If it will come to the right hand side, then it will become plus. And 15 is here plus, there is no sign is plus. So if it will come to this side, then it will become minus. So P is equal to minus 15. Or you can do this directly also. P is equal to minus 15. Just this sign I will do for this answer. Let's solve next example. transferred to the right hand side. So right hand side 24 as it is, 3 will transfer, so it will become 21. Here it is multiplied. Now if we will transfer to the right hand side, then it will become DY. So we easily go to see 3 ones are 3, 3 8s are 24. So it is the answer. P is equal to A. Now question number A. 3s is equal to minus 9. 3s is equal to minus 9. We are going to separate the variable. Now which number is with variable? 3 times s. 3 is with variable. So 3 times s means multiplication is there. Yes. So we are going to shift this 3 to the right hand side. Then it will become dy. Here what will remain? Yes. We are going to transfer 3 to the right hand side. So minus 9 divided by 3. Okay. So s is equal to 3. We will give them minus 10 as it is for this. Yes, division you know. Yes, division of integers you know. One number is negative, another is positive. So answer will be the negative. Understood everyone? So s is equal to minus 3. Let's solve exercise 4.3 question number 1. Solve the following equations. Solve the following equations. See a question. 2y plus 5 upon 2 is equal to 37 upon 2. Yes? Now see. 2 is with the variable. This 2 is with the variable. Okay. So now plus 5 upon 2. This is our number. This number is with the variable. So we are not going to touch for this number with the variable. Which number we are going to transfer? 5 upon 2. Which number we are going to transfer? 5 upon 2. First, you are not allowed to touch these numbers. Okay? This number is with variable. You are not allowed to touch with this number first. Okay? First, which number we are going to transfer? 5 upon 2 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. Now, 5 upon 2. What is the sign for 5 upon 2? Plus. Here it has plus sign. If we will transfer 5 upon 2 to the right hand side, then it will become minus. Now which number we are going to transfer? 5 upon 2 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. So left hand side 2y as it is. We are going to transfer this number to the right hand side. So again don't write this number here. What you are going to write is equal to sign 37 upon 2 as it is. And now this plus 5 upon 2 will transfer to the right hand side, then it will become minus 5 upon 2. Okay, minus 5 upon 2. Now see here, this fraction means like fraction. Yes, both of them they have denominators same. Yes, 37 upon 2 minus 5 upon 2. See, both the denominators are equal. So we can do the subtraction. So 2y as it is. First we are going to solve this 37 minus 5, 32. 32 upon 2. Yes, 32 upon 2. Now again we are going to solve this. Yes, 2y is equal to 32 upon 2 is 2 and 13. 6 are 12. So answer we got here 16. 16 we got now 2y is equal to 16. Yes, here every time we put there for 16. Okay, so 2y is equal to 16. Then now y, we have to separate the variable now. Okay, so 2 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. 2 is here multiplied. If we will transfer to the right hand side, then it will become dy. So y is equal to 16 upon 2. 16 divided by 2. Here it is multiplied. So if it will come to this side, then it will become dy. So y is equal to 16. Okay. So what is the value of y? Y is equal to 8. Y is equal to 8. Now let's solve the expression. 5t plus 28 is equal to 10. 5t plus 28 is equal to 10. Now see, 5 is with variable. 5 is with variable. 5 is preparing. So we are going to transfer which number now? 28 to the right hand side. Now 28 is here plus. If we will transfer 28 to the right hand side, then it will become minus. So we are going to transfer 28 to that side. So what will remain here? 5t is equal to 10 as it is. Now which number we are going to transfer? 28. 28 is left hand side, it is plus. If it will come to the right hand side, then it will become minus. Minus 28. Okay. Now, 5t is equal to. Now see, 10 is plus and 28 is minus. One number is positive, another number is negative. So what we are going to do? Subtraction. What we are going to do? Subtraction. So subtract 10 from 28. What will get? 80. And for answer, greater number sign. For answer, greater number sign. Now write this sign and check which is greater. 28 is greater. So which sign we are going to put here? Minus. Understood? For answer, greater number sign. Now see, next step. Now we have to separate the variable. So 5 is here multiplied. If it will come to right hand side, then it will become divided. Therefore, now what will be here? T. We are going to transfer 5 to the right hand side. So it will be divided. Yes, so it will be divided. So what is our answer? T is equal to minus 18 upon 5. So what is our answer? T is equal to minus 18 upon 5. Let's solve our next example. 8 upon 5 plus 3 is equal to 2. Now, which number we are going to transfer first? These 3 we are going to transfer first. Yes? So, A upon 5, as it is, here it is plus 3. If it will come to the right hand side, then it will become minus 3. Yes? It will become minus 3. So, therefore, A upon 5 is equal to, see, now 2 is plus and 3 is minus. Plus minus minus. Plus minus minus. So subtract 2 from 3. What will get? 1. And for answer, greater number sign. For answer, greater number sign. Now 2 and 3. Which is greater? 3 is greater. So 3 has minus sign. So for answer, minus sign. Now it is A divided by 5. 5 is divided. We need to separate the variable. Now what we are going to do? A is equal to. Now here 5 is divided. If it will come to the right hand side, then it will become multiplied. So minus 1 as it is. 5 is here divided. If it will come to this side, then it will become multiplied. So multiply by 5. So therefore A is equal to minus 1 multiplied by 5. 5 ones are 5. See, one number is negative and another is positive. Their product is negative. Their product is negative. So for answer, negative sign. See, in multiplication, one number is positive, another number is negative. Then their product is negative. Their product is negative. So A is equal to minus 5. Okay. A is equal to minus 5. Let's draw the next example. Q upon 4 plus 7 is equal to 5. Okay. Now see here. This number is alone. See, Q upon 4. This is the variable. First, which number we are going to transfer? 7 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. So here 7 is plus. If it will come to the right hand side, then it will become minus. So here what will you get? Upon 4. Which number we are going to transfer? Plus 7 we are going to transfer. So 5 as it is. Plus 7 we are transfer. Plus 7 we are going to transfer. So it will become minus 7. Okay. So Q upon 4 is equal to 5 minus 7. See, 5 is plus. 7 is minus. Plus minus minus. Subtract 5 from 7, 2. What is the answer? 2. 5 minus 7, 2. Now in this, which is greater number? 5 or 7? 7 is greater. So which sign 7 has? Negative. So for answer, negative sign. Now see, Q divided by 4. multiply. Okay, so therefore Q, we are going to separate the variables. So Q will remain here. Is equal to minus 2. 4 we are going to transfer to the right hand side. 4 is here divided. It will come to the right hand side, then it will become multiply. Thank you.